I know you're gonna dig this.
I don't understand what's going on here.
Hey guys, happy Sunday. This is what happened, but you weren't here, so you missed it. Are you having a good day, Mr. Puppy?
Puppy is beautiful.
Aw, he's being such a good boy. Lucy's passed out over there. Maddie's doing her 30-day ab challenge. How's it going?
It's good. I just have the reverse crunches left. Today is 9.
You still have a 1-pack?
I guess. I'm starting to see some...
Definition?
I think so.
Excellent.
So let's do some reverse crunches.
Okay.
Ready?
Ready.
One, two. I'm not sure how long you're supposed to hold it.
Shouldn't you be doing that like on a mat?
Well, I figured it's a quick thing, so.
Yeah, but I mean, that floor is pretty hard on your back, especially when you don't have any back fat.
Whatever.
Seven.
99, yeah. 100. And
9. Oh, you have to do the amount of the day?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's 10 of everything else and 9 of that, and then tomorrow's 10 of everything, and then the next day we add on the last move.
Oh.
Which is the crisscross.
Crisscross sounds painful.
Raise your hand if you're still doing the challenge!
Looks like you're the only one.
No.
Raise your hand in the comments.
I know you're out there.
Alright. Today I'm making something from vegan cooking for carnivores for Granny's house, so... I didn't have a lot of stuff in the house, even though I went shopping last night. I didn't buy those things because I didn't have any idea of what I was going to make. And tomorrow's shopping day anyway, so... I do like the veggies at Sam's Club the best because they seem to be a lot cheaper than the supermarket. So that's why I held off buying them. And I ordered a new cookbook that's coming on Friday, I hope. I think it's called, let me see what it's called. I don't want to get it wrong, because if anybody is, like, following along, I don't want to say the wrong thing. It's called, where is it? But I Could Never Go Vegan. And basically, it's a vegan cookbook. It looks like, let me see if I can pick this up, show you guys. What the cover looks like, But I Could Never Go Vegan. I saw this along with Thug Kitchen at Barnes & Noble the other day when we went, and I was really intrigued by it. They seem to have some really amazing recipes in there, and a lot of them are gluten-free as well. They're claiming that, you know, this will make vegan believers, you know, like a lot of people have excuses on why they don't want to go vegan, or you know, they're afraid that there's nothing that they can eat. But we'll see what happens when we get this cookbook. I'll make some of the recipes and you guys can judge, and the rest of my family who does not want to go vegan can judge. I'm hoping to do like at least one vegan day a week to start, to like be healthier. So we'll see what happens. It'll all start on Friday. Money late as usual. Here's the red beans and rice, my version.
Yeah.
Vegetarian. And we're also having some Spanish rice, sour cream, Vermont white cheddar, scallions. We got all the fixings going on there. You know what I got to say about that?
Yummy.
Yummy. So we're just going to pack this up. The dogs are on their final out. Lucy is coming with. Flash gets to relax. And we'll see the real star of the show. You guys know who.
Granny!
Ivanita Granny! Yay! All right, Mark built himself a nice plate of red beans and rice here. What do you think, honey?
Johnny, you and your napkin.
Delicious.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I hope you enjoy.
What does it say? Yeah. Yeah, read Grandma the story, okay?
My turn.
Okay, your turn.
No more your turn.
Sean.
My turn.
The story.
Wait, one November night. Stand up, report. What? BC. Chin. Over his lips. Wait. There was a knock at the door. He hid out the cable with the There's a look certain from it at the toy floor.
Okay, good. You want to hold the book and sit down over here and read it? Go ahead, sit down and read everybody the story. That's a Christmas story.
Read it loud, Shawnee.
The elves are not happy, but need to think that toy delivery is not disappointing. Huh? So there, others are one giving name that idea. And Santa, the reindeer king, lives. Yeah, but Santa down the hall.
You like that story?
Good job, buddy.
Good.
Thanks, Sean.
You should have him read at home like that, too.
Yeah, we never do that.
He doesn't sit for that. He only does that for you, Granny. Huh? He only does that for you.
Oh, he should do it at home,
He
too.
Reads to himself all the time. He's got a whole library of books in his room.
That's good.
Lucy's passed out.
Well, don't you like him to read your story once in a while? Well, you should, you know. That's good for him, you know. It stimulates his brain. Mm-hmm. That's what you want.
Hello.
You can clean off the table now? I gotta load the dishwasher so we can go. Chop, chop.
What's going on here?
Oh, it's dessert buffet. Welcome. Bienvenue.
Yay.
Make your selections. I gotta take my hearing aid out because it's annoying me now.
Yeah. So we finished up Downton for the evening. So now we are enjoying some Golden Globes red carpet. And then, are we even going to get to the Golden Globes tonight? I would like to, but I don't know if it's going to happen.
I don't know if we're going to get to all of them, but...
It's already after midnight.
After midnight!
I have managed not to spoil all the awards, which is unusual.
I'm
going to have one tomorrow, because I already had one before, and I'm...
I love them, so...
Of course.
It's weird now, because I can barely hear out of this ear, because it's so used to being, like, bombarded. Puffy and Lulu, you're so tired.
She is so tired.
Lucy was knocked out after we got home. Oh, yeah, hedgehog nuggets. Couple of these. One kiss.
Nice.
All right, a couple more of those. Did you have fun today?
Yeah.
It was good seeing Granny. We haven't seen her for a while.
Of course, I love seeing Granny. Whoops.
We had a good dinner. What'd you think of that red bean and rice?
That was delicious.
Really good. Guys, this was, thank you, by the way. That was from the Vegan Cooking for Carnivores cookbook. Now that it's a new year, I'm going to be showing you guys a lot more recipes and cookbook recommendations. I kind of dropped the ball. I know a lot of people were interested in what cookbooks that I like because they want to eat 1 to 7 days a week vegetarian, or they're trying to go vegetarian. We kind of have a unique situation in our family. Maybe not so unique, where some of us are vegetarian, some of us are flexitarian. So,
some of us just eat whatever you make.
Yeah. But, yeah, because Mark definitely has not given up meat. And a lot of people are, you know, considering going vegetarian, but not everybody in the family wants to go vegetarian, and they don't want to have to make a million different meals. Mm-hmm. So we're going to give you a little bit more insight into how we handle that in our family. Because you shouldn't be limited. You know, if you don't want to eat meat and the rest of your family wants to eat meat, we're going to give you some options. and we're going to give you some really tasty meals, thank you, that the rest of the meat eaters won't mind eating. Because they won't miss the meat with those meals. I hope.
Yeah.
I hope they're probably, oh, this tastes like crap. No, it won't. It'll be good.
So.
It'll be good. Mark's a diehard meat eater, so for him to eat vegetarian, it says a lot. So that's the story with that. I don't know what the story for tomorrow is going to be because we're supposed to be getting, excuse me.
Yeah.
Give her a kiss. We're supposed to, excuse me. We're supposed to be getting some icy conditions tomorrow, so. All right, Lucy, get down.
Get down.
Sean's really digging this potholder. He's been walking around with it for days. Bang, bang, Sean. Bang, bang into the room. All right, I guess that's Sunday night. We'll keep you informed for tomorrow. I don't know if we're going shopping until Tuesday. What's up, kiddo?
Thanks for watching. Until next time, much love.
Excellent.